amount of times I've been from San Francisco to LA in the past year. Here to there, back to here. Maybe 30. I don't know. I'm not good at guessing. Usually I fly, sometimes I drive. Today, I'm gonna bike. The plan is to head south along Highway 1 and camp along the way. 8 days with stops in Santa Cruz, Monterey, Big Sur, San Simeon, Pismo Beach, Santa Barbara, and Malibu. If we don't get lost, it should be just under 500 miles, which works out to about 60 miles a day for 8 days, from San Francisco to the Ferris Wheel and the Santa Monica Boardwalk. Simple enough, I guess. Gonna get to you, get to you, get to you
someday. Skip.
I immediately fell in Golden Gate Park. Got blindsided by a curb and went down like a pile of bricks. But as my old college cross coach used to say, suffer now and live the rest of your life like a champion. So in an effort to make him proud, I ignored some laughing teenagers, fixed my chain, and got rolling again. I guess part of the motivation for this trip is to soak in California at a slower pace. You can see a lot at 20 miles per hour. I've lived here my entire life, but this fall I'm moving to Boston, and it felt like a good opportunity to appreciate California a mile at a time. The mess I made is the mess you
made. Huh. It's gonna get to you, get to you, get to you someday. Skip.
Day 3, I was starting to feel the miles. My left leg was killing me and my back was on fire. Each morning, it felt like I was preparing for war.
Gets into your battle positions, repetition. We're addicted to pushing, fighting, bickering. And I follow my convictions. My direction is changing, of course. I couldn't wait for you for my entire life. I hope you make it to someone who treats you right. And when you think of me, I hope that all your memories are sweet. But I don't want to walk around the issue for forever.
Somewhere along the way, I developed a deep fascination with old mailboxes. It's kind of funny the things you think about while you're on the road. Most of the time I thought about Carly, though. She was going to bike too, but got sidelined by a knee injury, so she took a Subaru instead. I met Carly when I was a freshman in college. We lived in the same dorm, and she asked if I wanted to go for a run. I didn't really know how to run, so after a few miles, I asked her to stop so that I could catch my breath. And maybe that was another reason to bike to LA. Just to prove to Carly that my endurance had improved since I was 18. And that was put to the test in Big Sur. I had to do about half the climbing of the trip over the course of 2 days. But I figured these were good problems to have. I'd rather be climbing hills in Big Sur than just about anywhere else.
I've found a way to make it better. Look around and hopefully.
you'll see what I have seen. Cause I need to be, I need to be free. I think I need to focus on me.
I think my legs eventually figured, well, okay, I guess this is what we do now. Saturday, May 8th, final day of the ride. I just wrote down some closing thoughts. I think I'm having the time of my life. Usually it takes retrospect to come to a conclusion like that, but I'm pretty acutely aware of it as it's happening right now. How lucky am I that there's a girl who, despite not being able to bike herself, still loaded up a car and followed me along for the journey. The weather's perfect too, which I promised myself I wouldn't obsess over, but still, it's worth mentioning. It's perfect. And lastly, my mind feels clear and focused. Maybe the meditation's been helping, but I feel like I'm capable of being consciously mindful of my surroundings throughout the day, perfectly present. But when my mind does wander and think about the future, I'm excited for that too. For Boston and MIT, for the summer, for early mornings and more bike rides. For Carly, especially for Carly.
And after 478 miles, I pulled up to the Santa Monica boardwalk and it was over. All there was left to do was climb up here and ride the Ferris wheel. I've been dreaming about it all week.